Hey guys, this is Solrac333, and here we have a before of a little dollhouse that Mrs. Solrac333 is going to paint. After 14 years of customizing, she will now have an attempt of her own.
I'm gone. Mm-hmm.
And just move around. And you don't want to do too much in the beginning. Yeah, that's good for now.
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna get on the sides too.
I think it's okay now.
Just cover as much as you can. Alright, so here is what Mrs. Solrac333 did, and we went with the matte black, the Krylon Fusion matte black paint. I told her how I used to use the flat black, but they don't sell those anymore, so we went with matte black. And you know, the plan here is to turn this dollhouse into a haunted dollhouse, and this is going to be totally her project. I'll give her some pointers, but she's going to do whatever she wants with it. Now, if it were up to me, I would have painted everything black, but she wants to keep that original plastic to make it look like faded paint. Like maybe this was a nice mansion back in the day, and then other people have moved in over time and repainted it in their style, and then has been abandoned. That paint has faded to reveal the original paint underneath. So that's pretty cool. I would never have thought of that. That's totally my wife's idea. So yeah, we're keeping that original plastic. So, pretty neat. Can't wait to see what this looks like. Thank you.
and then wipe it.
Mm-hmm. And the wipe doesn't have to be perfect, just...
Yeah.
And just repeat. This is Solrac333 has started applying the paints, and for the outside she started applying some gray dry brushing on some of the bricks and the shingles. She's used some of my tester's paints, but then she also bought her own paint from Michael's. Inside, you can see the brown dry brushing on the for the wood. She started moving furniture in the house. For the parts that weren't spray painted fully, she did a little black wash to dirty it up. More dry brushing. The walls were also painted. And each floor is going to have a different color on the wall. I think this one came out nice. That's the original sticker that that we covered up, or she covered up, and then peeled it off, and then dirtied it up to make it look like the painting has been there for a while. And the top floor, it's going to use all of the colors from, this has purple, somewhere in there is purple. This has kind of a teal blue. I think this floor looks spooky with those colors. This one has kind of a pinkish color. And this floor will have all three. The rug has been painted. I think she's gonna do a little black wash to dirty it up. And this was neat. She was going to paint all three colors, but then change her mind and try to remove the paint and scratch it off. But it gave it a neat, weathered look, as if the people that moved into this house started painting and then didn't like the color and tried to scrape it off. And then they were scared out of this mansion. This spooky haunted mansion. Bathroom. And the balcony with some of that gray dry brushing. So yeah, it's coming along nicely. We'll see how this winds up looking when finished. Alright, so here is what my wife has so far. Some very light gray dry brushing for the roof. A little bit on the walls and on the bricks right there. I think for now she's gonna keep it this way. So I think this video might be like a part one. But she did start adding some furniture. Some people have started to move in. You got the creature there. Got a man bat. Frankenstein's monster, mummies. And this guy. She's got some rugs. We're gonna use, well, she's gonna use some of the McFarlane toys. Box art as portraits. Got the Bride of Frankenstein. Snoke has decided to move in. Another Snoke to lounge around. The Wolfman. The organ. More rugs. Another man bat. With some bats. Got Dracula. His coffins. This will be the baby's room. So yeah. And I think she's going to take her time with this project. So far so good. So when we update this, I will keep you posted. Thanks for watching, guys.